So when I practice in the PPG endocrinology clinic, many of my patients ask about the COVID vaccine and whether or not they should consider receiving it. As we treat both type 1 and type 2 diabetes patients, we strongly encourage that they consider getting the vaccine as soon as that they are eligible. That's because diabetes, we know from clinical data and from evidence published by the Centers for Disease Control, that persons with diabetes are at greater risk for both hospitalization and severe illness from COVID-19. Being vaccinated helps protect you against that risk. The vaccines are 95% effective at preventing COVID-19 illness, so it provides a very, very high level of protection. There are a range of different autoimmune conditions that we manage in the field of endocrinology. Some of the autoimmune conditions that we see in endocrinology are certain types of thyroid disease, type 1 diabetes, and also certain forms of adrenal insufficiency. All of the patients that have those conditions, we encourage to get the COVID-19 vaccine once they become eligible. If a patient has another type of autoimmune condition, such as rheumatoid arthritis or another rheumatic condition that might be managed by a rheumatologist, or another autoimmune condition that might require treatment to suppress the immune system, it's very important that you speak with your doctor about vaccination. Although it may be safe to receive the vaccine, the body's immune response may be affected if you are on certain medications that suppress the immune system. So we always recommend speaking with your physician, particularly the specialist that manages your autoimmune condition, to understand when and how you should be vaccinated for COVID-19. The clinical trials for both the Moderna and the Pfizer vaccine included a wide and diverse range of volunteers. Between the two different phase 3 trials that were completed, approximately 74,000 volunteers were enrolled. And many of those individuals had chronic health conditions, including things such as diabetes, heart disease, lung problems, kidney disease, or other autoimmune disorders. What is very reassuring is that in people with chronic health conditions, the vaccine was equally effective. So across different age groups, gender, race and ethnicity, presence or absence of certain chronic health conditions, all of those groups of volunteers that received the vaccine had a similar 95% reduction in the risk of COVID-19 illness after vaccination. Both vaccines were extensively studied and have been shown to be very safe. There's active safety monitoring going on nationwide, and we're collecting a wealth of experience with real-world use of the vaccine in the U.S. population. So far, we have continued to see not only excellent safety, but very good results in terms of tolerability and effectiveness of the vaccine. Over time, we're going to continue to collect data on its safety and effectiveness as more and more people become vaccinated in the U.S.